Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the Thousand Trails Insider, Carolina Landings in South Carolina. Today I'll be giving you a tour of the park, and it is September 2022. This campground is basically located on the shores of Lake Hartwell in a town called Fair Play, South Carolina, which has been here since 1833. As you make your way to the campground, you're going to find yourself here in the middle of what is somewhat a rural and residential area. This is a cute little town, but it does not have many amenities. Outside of the fire station and a post office, that's about what you have here. A little further away in the opposite direction of Fair Play, you will find a Dollar General, and I believe there's a gas station in that town as well. The areas that surround the campground are a great place to ride your bike. You'll find some interesting historic places and some really beautiful scenery. Once you arrive at the campground, you'll find yourself here at the main entry driveway. The main entry will be on the left-hand side of the road that you come in on. As you make your way up the check-in road here, you'll notice the check-in station further up. You'll see the gate, but you'll want to stop before that. There's a stop line there. That's where you'll stop and go up to the ranger station and check in. Don't go to the right here. That's where everyone's going to go around you when you're stopped. After you've been assigned to a site and given your check-in materials, you should be escorted to your site to make it a little bit easier to know where you're going. The check-in gate uses a gate code, and that changes weekly, so make sure you're updated on that information. This is the ranger station, and it's located to the right of the check-in station. Just behind the ranger station is where you'll find many of the park's amenities, including the volleyball pits and the children's playground, both of which seem to be in really good condition. And just across from the playground is where you'll find the mini golf. Although the putt-putt course isn't extremely elaborate, it is extremely usable. The AstroTurf seemed to be pretty new and in good condition. The course was fairly clean, the paint colors weren't too faded, and the obstacles looked pretty good. As I've said in previous videos, to me, often the condition of the mini golf course represents the condition of the entire campground. And in the case of this campground, that pretty much hits the nail right on the head. The golf course also had nice clean benches to have a seat and was set in a beautiful park-like setting. And next is the basketball court, which was about in the same condition as the mini golf course, which means it's very usable. Also in this same area, you'll find the laundry room and restroom facilities. There is also cornhole games for you to check out, as well as a Pepsi machine if you get a little thirsty. The laundry room seemed to be pretty adequate, as well as fairly clean. The machines are updated with credit card readers and app versatility, so you can check the status of your wash from your rig. There's also a couple benches outside if you just want to hang out and wait. Right behind the laundry is where you'll find the pool. This is a well-maintained pool that seems to have been updated recently. I also noticed a very clean exterior shower and a recently resurfaced pool deck. The pool area also had plenty of shaded cabanas and plenty of lounge chairs. I believe the pool is one of the first places you and the kids are going to want to hang out at this campground. As you get further into the park, you'll notice there are quite a few annual campsites here. As a Thousand Trails member, you can often find this makes things difficult to get a reservation, so you want to make your reservations early at this campground. And just so you know, this park does have many hills in it and many rough roads. A lot of the corners are also very tight, so navigating a big rig through here can be difficult at times. The section that I'm showing you now is actually one of the easier areas to navigate, and we were lucky enough to get in this area. There's our rig right there. Next to us is an empty site, so you can get an idea of how long and how wide the sites actually are. In this area, I'm going to show you where some of those hills are. I'm going to speed up the tape just a little bit so we can fly through this a little faster. I'm not too sure how well this is going to come out on video, but I can tell you, much like the rest of the park, these are some pretty gnarly hills. All in all, I'd have to say this is a pretty beautiful park. And September was a great time to visit. There are quite a few interesting things to do around the area, including some awesome state parks. As for Christy and myself, we found it to be a pretty cool place to ride our e-bikes. That is, if we had enough power to get up some of these hills. The good thing on an e-bike is, what goes up must go down, and we had a great hill to ride down. This park isn't too huge, but I still have a couple more things I'd like to show you, including this place, which is the event center. Unfortunately, when we visited the park, they had absolutely no events going on here. The building was completely locked and closed to guests and members. On the side of the event center, there was also an area that was like a barbecue and picnic area, closed off to members and guests. Well, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video by checking out the restroom facilities. Of course, I could only check out the men's restroom, so you'll have to leave the rest to your imagination. But the men's restroom seemed to be in pretty good shape. The floors and the facilities were all really clean, and you didn't get that kind of gas station restroom scent when you came in here. The shower stalls were open, and they were all clean. The checkoff material was all recently signed, and the safety stuff was all right there. On the RV bandwagon scale of awesomeness, this rates a 7 out of 10. I hope you enjoyed this inside look at the Carolina Landings Thousand Trails 2022. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already done so, as I have more insider videos coming up soon, as well as other interesting videos that I think you will enjoy.